Thank you very much, Madam Deputy Speaker. From a Waveney, a Suffolk and an East Anglian perspective, this budget is very much a step in the right direction, but there is a great deal of work remaining outstanding and some anomalies that need to be corrected. Much good work is already underway. In Lowestoft, construction has already started on two vitally important infrastructure projects, the Gullwing Bridge and the Lowestoft Flood Defence Scheme, and East Suffolk Council are busy working up details of the various projects that are included in the successful Towns Fund bid, which was announced in the March budget. From a Suffolk perspective, Madam Deputy Speaker, the headline from the budget was the provision of £1.7 billion of new direct government funding to enable a large-scale nuclear project to proceed, with Sizewell C very much in mind. This funding is linked to the nuclear financing bill, which has its second reading on Wednesday. Subject to the development consent order being granted, construction will start next year on a project that can bring enormous benefits to Suffolk people and businesses, and it is vital that after the 12-year construction period has ended, that we leave a lasting legacy of knowledge, skills and infrastructure. Investment in infrastructure is very important, but to achieve meaningful levelling up, there is a need for investment in people, so that they have the skills to secure the well-paid and exciting jobs that are emerging in the green economy and new technology. It is welcome that the government recognised this and are funding the Lifetime Skills Guarantee and are continuing to provide the Education Recovery Fund. However, I do have some concerns. There is no commitment to increasing the funding per student for adults. By the end of 2024-25, this would not have gone up for 14 years. And there is a worry that there is a lack of support for level 1 and 2 qualifications. Level 3 qualifications and T-levels have a very important role to play, but one does need to put in place those rungs on the ladder that are needed so that as many people as possible are able to embark on that lifetime learning journey. Madam Deputy Speaker, in the time remaining to me, there are two barriers that need to be removed that I will address, that if we are going to deliver meaningful and enduring levelling up in the east of England. I shall briefly highlight these. It was very disappointing that the New Anglia LEPS proposal for a regional fund has not been accepted. Along with the South East and London, to which we are very, very different, we are now the only areas in the UK without such a facility. In the same vein, it is very concerning that on page 56 of the Red Book, it is explicitly stated that government spending on research, development and innovation will be invested outside of London, the South East and the East of England. From an East Anglian perspective, I strongly urge the government to review this, as Suffolk and Norfolk are very different to London and the Home Counties. A failure to recognise this will undermine levelling up, particularly in coastal East Anglia that I represent. Thank you.